Hello everybody, this is Richard Cespedes, and we're here to play Ghostbusters for the Xbox 360.
Are you troubled by strange noises in the night?
And, man, I'm just excited to play this game. It's been a while since I played it, but...
Have you or your family actually
There's old Bill Murray. Everybody loves Bill Murray.
If the answer is yes, then don't wait another minute.
Just pick up the phone and call the professionals. What a great time for filmmaking.
Ghostbusters, we're ready to believe you.
Franchises available soon. Call for
details. Dan Aykroyd actually, Russell, Hell Ramis actually wrote a script for this game, you know?
Yeah, why?
And man, playing this game through, they really did a good job. They really did an awesome job.
I hear something.
The lighting,
wanna hear something really creepy?
Color, everything's fantastic.
Shandor, you know, the guy who donated most of the Gozer stuff? He was into the occult.
Very theatrical, you know, and cinematic.
Supernatural. Weird dude.
Why don't we talk about it sometime?
Has a nice, great feel to it.
Any other time.
Hey, you can't be in here. Stop!
Oh, yeah. This gives you goosebumps, huh? Here it comes. Wait for it. Yeah. Ghostbusters. Starring Bill Murray. Dan Aykroyd and Harold Ramis. I mean, that's written by Dan Aykroyd and Harold Ramis.
Ghostbusters, is your haunting an apparition?
And she actually looks very sexy.
Wraith,
wait till she stands up, you'll see.
The tortured solar. What? No, we do not summon dead family members and catch them so
Looking
you can
good.
Ask the combination to the safe. Yeah, well, same to you, pal.
Hey, it's the new cadet!
Now I want to start off by just
this
complimenting
a little dangerous.
These people on making
Great.
The proton pack
Danger
look so damn badass.
We'll start at 50%
look at that
capacity.
Thing.
That should keep any burning or tissue damage.
Wish I owned a real proton
hey, if you're
pack,
gonna
man.
Burn any tissue, do it to the new kid. You can't use Ray.
Like, the nice facial animation, too.
I guess he's right. What's your name again, kid?
No names, Ray. I don't want to get too attached to this kid. You know, just in case. You remember what happened to the last kid.
And it's so awesome that they actually used the real.
He's tuned and ready to go.
People, Bill Murray and Dan Aykroyd to actually do the voiceover work for this game.
Good.
I mean, it just really sells it.
We perfected an extensive
awesome.
And rigorous training regimen that will teach you all your equipment's basic functions.
And you know
Take
what? They sound like they haven't even
skill, but it's
aged.
Definitely worth
like
the
they sound exactly the same like in the movie Ghostbusters 1 and 2. It's awesome.
Was that us?
I don't think so.
Ray?
Had to be some sort of psi energy pulse. Substantial, a significant collected and centralized necromantic convulsion, level 7 or more.
Agreed. We need EMF measurement checks now.
Slammer going crazy.
Answer, but I'm gonna ask anyway, is
Looking.
A level 7, whatever,
Looking good.
Bad or very bad?
On a scale of 1 to 10, I would say...
Let me guess, it's a 7.
Let's just say we're about to get real busy.
Now we're gonna get straight into it. I would usually wander around because this place is just so huge. You see the bedrooms in there.
Wait, come back.
The pole, classic pole. But I'm just gonna get straight into it. Interacting with objects.
There it is. It seems oddly drawn to the containment grid.
The proton packs look like little Christmas trees.
Okay, easy now, cadet. I'll talk you through this.
It's almost hypnotic.
Proton stream to get his attention.
That's not the containment unit. That's some highly sensitive equipment you're disintegrating there, kid. Oops, you let one out?
That's my fault. I was fine-tuning the interspace gas.
And the stream.
You can get those ghosts.
I mean, look at that.
He went into the sub-basement.
It looks exactly like in Ghostbusters 1 and 2.
Kid, we got a job for you.
It has the blue and it has the red. Exactly like in the movie.
Not sure about the other guy though. Okay, let's go get him. Oh, and don't sweat the containment unit.
Now we're getting into action.
Get excited your first time out with the proton stream. Egon will fix it in no time.
I like that mist around there.
Now, first and foremost, before things get out of hand, you want to get to know your proton.
There's Slimer.
It can be your best friend out there in the field. Everything you need to know is displayed on the
and,
pack itself.
And not even in the film that they talk about having this condition. Deep basement. They never the bomb, referred to it, I think, in the movies. And still stay on your feet. It's very interesting how they have it in there. And I like this too, how they don't have the life bar in the top corner like in typical games. Most games they don't, but the life bar is those green bars right there, so
we break it into three basic steps.
You could see it, you know, you just have to keep an eye on it.
The first step is blasting a ghost to sap its energy. Do it again! See that overlay on the ghost? It indicates the current accumulation of a ghost PKE. The more you disperse, the weaker it becomes. Pack's moving into the red, Cadet Bennett!
And of course, they had to create different type of mechanics. Whoa, got me there. For the game. You know, that's what makes the Ghostbusters universe more alive and more complex and more rich, because they made the game to where you're zapping Slimer. In the movie, you know, you would I think if I'm incorrect, I haven't seen it for a long time, but in the movies you would just zap them to get them, and then you would grab them and then bring them into the ghost trap. But here you have to drain them, zap them, and then drain them, and then grab them and then put them in the ghost trap. And I like this too, because you get to look at the information about the ghosts, which makes it more richer and more detailed. Video games help out a lot in making the movie franchises more interesting and more to ponder. You know, because in video games you get to put in more things than you would in the movie, and you get to analyze them and enjoy it more. It draws you in to the franchise of the game and film that it came from. And I'm sorry I'm spending time reading a lot. I'll be doing that a little bit, but I'll be trying to be quick about it. I'm trying to just show, you know, how much story there is to each character. There's going to be a lot of different ghosts. That's how rich this game is and how Dan Aykroyd wrote the story. It's very dense, with lots of things to ponder about. I like how they designed this ghost character. Ugh.
All right, you've got it good and windy. Next stage, capital. You can project
sound.
A capture stream or wrangler manually using this control. On the other hand, the pack will detect when a ghost is sufficiently weakened and auto-select the capture stream setting. Get in there and throw a capture stream on that tub of goo.
It just takes a little time. Well, we should be getting him pretty soon. We're getting wrapped up. There you go. Then we just slam him. I think in the film you slam him. I'm not too sure. Maybe I'm wrong. But it's just a good concept anyways for the game. And I like the way that spherical red light surrounds them. It's just so perfectly oriented. I love that. And there it goes. And look at this. Look how he stretches in. Just like in the movies when the ghost was stretching the ghost trap. I love that. It's so theatrically cinematic.
Very nice, Cadet.
You did a great
That's
job.
A real promise. Oh, and always remember to retrieve your trap.
Did you get them?
We're batting 500. Slimer slipped out. Our cadet bag is first.
Man, if this game came out in the 90s, it would blow all the other games straight to hell, man. I mean, this game, in a word, If this came out in the 90s, man, it goes for computers, obviously. It would blow all the games to hell, man. Like, this would blow everyone. Even the film industry would take notice of this.
Hey, how come this mump gets
everyone in the world
stuff?
Would be like, what the hell?
This game's experimental equipment
too
technician.
Graphically awesome.
He gets a cool title, too?
It means he gets to carry around a bunch of untested, extremely dangerous hardware that, if not handled correctly, could blow him somewhere into New Jersey.
Oh, this knucklehead lugs around our very dangerous prototype hardware that could potentially blow us into New Jersey. Thanks. Keep the title, kid.
And no one can replace Bill Murray, man. Nobody.
Scooter, we need to go. Let's roll.
Look at the ambiance, man. I mean, I just would love to be a Ghostbuster, man. We have the ride there. They say it'll be like a dream come true.
Ghostbusters.
Where to, Ray?
The Sedgwick Hotel. It's the first place that little Spud will go.
Right. Back to its initial manifestation point.
They've got a real good buffet.
It is a great one.
Now we're gonna head on out
when
to our real first
from the opera,
mission.
Extend an invitation to join us at our table at the Sedgwick.
Hey, you're up, buddy. Training will be on the job tonight. Try not to destroy too many Manhattan landmarks.
That's our job, but you can hear him. Is that a real place in New York?
That disgusting green blob is up on the 12th floor again, wreaking havoc. I demand a refund right now.
Sir, if you check the fine print on our invoice...
Invoices.
Right, invoices. You'll see that your warranty on rehaunting expired some time ago. You should have taken the extended service agreement.
And it's so awesome that Bill Murray, Dan Aykroyd, and Ramis, Harold Ramis, actually put their vocals down, you know,
dig up what you can.
Just for this game. You know, they came in and recorded their voices and they sound just enthusiastic. I mean, I don't know if there's anything that they said in the movie that's similar to this, I'm not too sure. That they would use those sound bites from the movies to make the game, but I'm pretty sure they recorded their voices,
well,
their original
hello.
Voice recordings.
You're perfectly safe now, miss. The Ghostbusters.
Just for this awesome game.
Back off, loser. Never gonna happen.
She kind of sounds like,
rarely works with me.
Our modern
I'll show
era girl.
You that later.
The women of our era.
All right, Ace. Get ready.
And I just can't say enough about those backpacks. Proton packs are awesome.
Proud to, Dr. Venkman.
Part of our settlement with the city, proton packs must remain off in heavily populated public areas.
And in close quarters. It minimizes the city's liabilities and satisfies the restraining order the maid here had put on us.
Where we live in today, you shoot a proton stream of highly charged particles at someone, they get all so happy. It's him!
Now we're just gonna wander around and explore. We're just gonna blast some things a little bit here and there.
Just a little patience while you're accelerated to full arrival.
And it's so great how every little detail, even that lighting, how that light fell down, the lighting is all crooked. Beautiful, man. Beautiful. This game is beautiful. It kind of even stands up for even the modern game. I can't say too much about the new Doom. That game is just too effing awesome, but this game stands up tall. Just love playing around.
What the? That looked painful. Are you okay? That way. Check your aim. Watch it. Contact. Yow!
Jeez! We're burning daylight, Pilgrim. Can we get out of here?
And I like how the couches kind of deteriorate, like they break apart exactly. Oh yeah, and the walls too, how they deteriorate.
All right, showtime. We wear him out, then we capture him. That's what your protons.
And you can tell that they also use references from the first Ghostbusters, because Simon was eating.
You've got him on the run. Come on, let's go, Peter.
The guest's food.
Nah, I've seen this one already. Know how it ends. You two have fun though. I'll cover the elevators and escort any ladies.
Yeah, okay. And this signal looks just like your elusive little targeted entity. Your meter will flash and buzz when it detects a potential signal. The pair of goggles are linked directly to your active PKE meter. This lets you see otherwise undetectable phenomena while you track it. Ghost trails, object auras, all kinds of cool events. Now when the center bar peaks, you're headed in the right direction. When it's flat,
and I love this too.
Line the target up with
I don't know if in the film. I love that green slime.
Okay, way to go.
How it just looks. Transparent green slime. And this actually gives you a better description of the ectoplasm than in the film. You know, Dan Aykroyd's character tried to explain it, and Harold Ramis tried to explain it, but here you get to read more detail about it. And the goggles too, I think that in the film you weren't able to really see exactly what they were seeing just at certain moments, but it just looks way better here.
Getting warmer. You're red hot. Getting a good scan is sort of like taking a good snapshot. When you've got an entity in range, hold the scan button. This will analyze. Not me, them. Whoa, he's definitely been here.
Pop that lamp. If we were real Ghostbusters and we're blasting things inside this hotel in real life, they'll think we're crazy.
Like a cursed artifact.
But this is the game world. I love that orange glow on that soda.
Then we roll it
machine.
Back into research and development. The extra funds let us experiment with new equipment and offensive technologies. Which in turn you get to wear on your back to test. Remember, you can always review techniques, tutorials, and equipment in your online Ghostbusters field manual. It's all accessible from your PKE meter.
Right! Oh, feel good!
Peter, come in. You okay?
Those proton packs look like Christmas trees all lit up. And see, like, little things like this gives you more information about the hotel and the history and certain things. It's just little things, little trinkets of information is so great.
Uh-oh, man down. We've got a man down. Go, go, go! Come on, shake a leg. You can move faster than that, catcher.
Help Peter.
Double time, cadet.
And actually, in real life, these...
Hey, over here.
These proton packs would cause even more damage than what is shown here. They'll blow through the damn walls and doors and... Things will be setting on fire.
Hey, over here, little help. Yo, little help.
He's been slimed again. Hustle over
and I love
here
how it
up.
Shows in the top left the cost of what you're breaking, what you need to pay
the
them.
Funk the fire again.
When one of us goes down, we always help each other out.
And I love how the doors in the elevators, it looks so. That was surreal, so dreamlike, you know, like a little
right now,
chessboard look to it. It's kind of a little eccentric little design and style.
Our live-in science experiment is tearing apart the lobby, and he's not alone.
More ghosts? but we gave this hotel a clean bill of health 5 years ago.
New people die every day.
Call the elevator, Junior.
Always going up and down this game.
All right, Slimer. You've had your fun.
Look at the facial
animation.
The
elevator's off limits.
It's pretty well done.
Done. Come in. I think we're stuck in the elevator.
Look at,
we
look
need
at Bill
some
Mary.
Help. Think we're stuck. Well, let's see. Think we're stuck. Think we're stuck. Think we're stuck. Ray, you guys good with officially stuck in the elevators? Show of hands.
Here it comes.
Kill it, Ray!
Need a hand?
You always fail.
Kill it, Ray. Yeah, it even wraps around that. Look how beautiful that looks.
For now, the ghost with the red cap is fighting hard to hold steady.
Even when it hits objects, it's beautiful.
He's a New York bellhop, just tipping, right? Uh oh, here they come. Good crack.
Oh yeah, these new beautiful design ghosts got me down. Bellhop ghost. Dang. So this whole hotel is like one cursed building. Time to kick some ass. Ooh, the piano shattered.
Climb! You stirred up a hornet's nest, kid.
There's a lot of action in this game.
Look behind you. Aim high.
Oh, that was a knockout right there. That was a Mike Tyson knockout.
Get out of here!
That's some major destruction.
It's a whole swarm.
The snake trails on the walls.
Hold on!
We're getting them. Slam! Ooh!
Ow! That was ow there!
Oh! That was more like a Mayweather knockout. It wasn't too bad. Oh, look at that. Look at that stretch. Look at them stretching and being pulled and beat. Oh! Gotcha! Oh, beautiful. Look at that. Spherical surrounding that ghost,
nice,
grabbing that ghost with your It's like a video game CGI triumph, this game.
Can we please call Winston and tell his night off is officially ended?
Oh, Sorry, guy. Mike, that was a Manny Pacquiao mount. About the same as Mayweather. Oh, that was a knockout. Come on. Come on, Slammer. Quit fighting it. Kind of reminds you of Left 4 Dead when you have to go pick up your friends and stuff.
They've split up.
Ray, follow me. The others are floating back upstairs.
And I love how when you release the pressure, how the little, the bottom part of the proton pack kind of sticks out. It went above and beyond with this game. They really did. Look at that sound. I'm acting like a destructive child, huh?
There, the Alhambra Ballroom. No way he could pass that up.
Absolutely not! You can't go in. The Rodriguez Bar Mitzvah is set to start in half an hour.
I'll bet the beef brisket is today's special.
And you've done quite enough already. I'm sure the thing will just go away. I'm willing to risk it. You're not going in there.
That's all we needed to hear. All right, we're out. Coffee time, everyone. Service has been declined beyond this point.
We'll find a way in there.
Sounds like the Alhambra's off limits.
The schnutz, you say? Nobody sees humans twice and gets away with it.
Be careful, Peter.
The plants, the plastic plants. It's like if they had one huge ass crazy rock party. That's how it would look. Love the tables, I'll be great.
Do you bring your apron? I'm gonna take a little shortcut through the kitchen. The Alhambra should be right through. Hello?
There we go in the kitchen. This is kind of like the what I consider to be the highlights of the game. Besides confronting, chasing after in the street, the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. I love that part, the second part of this whole game.
Okay, champion, you lead.
I'm sorry if I'm dragging on here, guys. Just, I haven't played this game for a while. I just want to mess around. We'll get to it, though. We'll get to it. That completely collapsed.
Like, don't touch the slime. It's slimy and it's extremely dangerous.
Ooh, look at that color. Black slime that's highlighted with a beautiful orange. I love the purple light in that pic. Slimer. And the level design is almost like a architectural design for a real home. I mean, the ones that they used to have back in the 90s, you know, remember when we were kids, they had the, oh man, that was a big explosion. I remember the architectural designing game that they had back there when I was a kid in school. Kind of reminds me of that. Papisar Grassy. Gassy, whatever his name is. Another great design for a ghost. And great backstory, too. Unluckiest fisherman who ever lived. More destruction. So much detail in this game, so much. So much interaction. I think there'll be way more damage to this area, blasting all around like that. Peter just standing around there. And I love these ghosts that are coming up, these fish. It's so weird how, like, the logic of the Ghostbuster universe is like everything that's alive, even the little, you know, little feeble little animal like a fish can be alive and be a nuisance, you know?
I dare you. Everything but the kitchen sink.
And they actually look like just strings of energy just flowing around. Dead fish flyer. You see, they come from the fish market, you know? Their spirits floating around. They're previous living bodies. It's very, very interesting. Maybe even roaches are able to be ghosts, nuisance ghosts in the Ghostbuster universe, huh? Man, they're like quick streaks in the air, aren't they? Looking to see if anything else can explode. I think that was just a one-time thing that they had. That one oven exploding, you know. Alright, let's get this thing out of the way. wrapping it up, throwing it away. Oh yeah, and I think that was the flower sacks exploding. Nope, I don't think anything else can explode around here. Alright, so right now, 1,475, but adding all of that all together, it's gonna be maybe 100,000 worth of damage throughout this game. Maybe even more. A little trinket there. Everyone, this one, Stay Puft figure. And I love how they talk about how they had a boom fad going on. I read this already. And that their city created figurines and merchandise back from Ghostbusters 1, where people acknowledged them. It's kind of this little thing that you're reading is like, it's almost realistic on how it would really be. I mean, how fickle people are. They forget their heroes, how great their heroes are. How great living legends are. Legends that live among them, you know? They lose respect. Gonna be looking around, see if there's anything else to analyze. Here we are, we snuck in. And as you know, causing more damage is what I do. And I love, here's Slammer. And I love how, watch when I blow up that kick. Watch when I hit that kick. I love how when the tablecloth just kind of like deteriorates. Like cream, like melted butter. I love how it does that.
I'm gonna take back, blast him until he's dazed, and then throw your cash.
Slimer's waiting for us. Ready to get some action on. Watch this. Plow. That's cool. I'm gonna get you, don't worry, I'm coming. Chandelier. He falls down like a sack of potatoes, huh? I'm gonna look for a little secret inside here. You'll see what I'm talking about.
Breathing hard.
in real life, the Ghostbusters would just remove, you know, they would fire my ass if I was just blasting around everything around me. Piano. Everything almost in this game is made to break. And here we are. Let's see, where did that little... Where's that little secret telling you guys about? Here we are. This is one of the biggest secrets in the game. One of the biggest ones. Now to be heading on back out. Now, to kick some ass. Get over here, Slammer. Get your ass in there. Get in there. Oh. Well, he was a fighter. I salute you.
Yeah, perfect. See? That's a big wow. Who teach that to a exact science? And by extension, you.
Kind of reminds me of the Ghostbuster toys. They always came in different colors. Egon came in like a baby blue color. The old toys in the 90s. I love those toys, man.
What have you done? The guests are arriving in 15 minutes.
What seems to be your problem?
Dan Aykroyd's character looked very different. I liked how they changed the look of that for the cartoon specifically.
Can now proceed in an entirely ghost-free environment. So, you're welcome. Huh? And, to the Rodriguez, L'chaim, from the Ghostbusters.
The cartoons were awesome, too.
Nice of you guys to join us.
I don't know how the new movie's gonna turn out. I mean, I think it's gonna be pretty decent. And I'll probably end up buying the DVD of it, but there's nothing that can replace the original.
Heads up, your initiation is over. Now give us a hand. We've got a couple of really resistant, troublesome spirits here.
And we're just bombarding them with these strings. Gotcha. Time for me to owe you what you gave to me. I fall, but I get right back up.
Look behind you!
I love how those pillars break apart.
Multiple contact! Eyes high!
Oh, I'm down.
And you would never know that these things would actually deteriorate, break apart. You would never know to appreciate them unless you actually just messed around like how I'm messing around. You know, you just appreciate these things, you know?
Boy, are you gonna get it now?
Look behind you! That's trouble!
And the pants flying there?
Oh. serious fast shooting force.
A lot of goddamn bellhops around here. Dead, deceased, blind bellhops. Ooh, flying suitcase. Everybody's got that. Get your ass in there. We jumped them, man.
Sure, now was it?
And the hotel owner hiding in the shadows.
No need to worry, sir.
Jumping out
from
the shadows.
Office on a strictly pro Ghostbusters platform, and we now invoice the city directly for all captures and eliminations. And unhaunted New York is a tourist-friendly New York.
No, but damage.
The mayor and the city have taken out an extensive insurance policy as well, so you're covered.
Honestly, I'm sensing some hostility here. Perhaps we should just leave the ghost here if that's what you would prefer, sir.
No, no. But please, be discreet.
Discretion is our professional watchword.
Hands up! Whoa! Where did he come from?
I suppose we should go after him, unless you want to discuss it first.
Cadet, go with Dr. Spengler. Check out the angry fisherman.
Summoner bell? I never knew they were called summoner bells. All right, let's get to it. As you can see, you can get a lot of exercise being a Ghostbuster. One of the benefits that they don't tell you about. Spiral staircase.
Looks like he's drifting upstairs.
Great design on that ghost. I love how they had the apparition-y fishes surrounding him. Now, this part, I'm going to be talking a lot about this. This part of the level, they really did an awesome job on. Look at that green, eerie light coming from there. Just gives us so much ambience, so much great interaction with this world. One of the first parts I want to talk about is this one coming up very soon. I wonder if we can really make a proton pack. That'll be awesome. Nice purple aura. Purple aura going on there. Now, it should be coming up pretty soon. Here it comes. Watch how everything transforms. Look at the transformation. The water falling off. Great sound effects. The mist. Coral.
More specifically, a 7,000 cubic meter bathtub filled with protonically
the
charged
sea sand. It's love it, man.
Sea cucumbers.
This lets you know that the particular boss is a fisherman, you know? It's a concept to coincide with the person that you're trying to pursue. Environmental concept is really, really great. Nice, creepy darkness to it. And great water physics, too. Oh, there he is.
Ray, did you tell the recruit about semi-dimensional rift entities? This type of highly agitated environment is a likely manifestation point.
And the barnacles, I think that's what they're called. Growing on the walls. Oh, creepy spiders. Candle spiders. And great design on the little enemies that they make. Went back up to heaven. Oh, you came out of nowhere. They're just coming out of the woodwork, aren't they? Now it's time to hunt down that fisherman. Just making sure. Another little secret, the famous little toaster. I think that's where they got it from, Dancing Toaster. He came out of there. Damn, it seems so thick of coral, man. You're completely underwater. Like, they just put all that shit in there. All that detail and environmental change. Damn, those barnacles are huge. Everything's just all bobbing and floating in the water. Whoa, even on the ceiling, all over the place. It's awesome. It disappears like if it never was there from the beginning. Here we are. Damage, damage, damage. Objective: capture the fisherman ghost. Guys, too damn quick. Halfway there, though. Then I'll be slamming your ass in the ceiling and the floor. Now you guys are here. They're probably just waiting out there, waiting for that his life meter to go down.
Are you all right?
Nice going. You might really be the right person.
Lazy bastards.
Yes, you have destroyed a significant section of a 5-star New York hotel in just under 3 hours. Your mother and I are so proud. Aren't we, Egon?
He's got something. Let's track it down.
There we go. Let's do this. Fight that big old damn monster. I love the design of this restaurant too. In the movie, they never spoke of this place, I think. But they just add new things in for the game. The bar is even named after him. Jaws Chompers there. Damn. Now we're gonna get you. Kitchen Golem. I can't even tell where his eyes are at. And out of all the other guys, he's gonna come straight at me most of the time.
It's generating a field of attraction so strong that it's able to reassemble us from the public apart.
Almost got you. Here we go. Get in there. Come on, don't fight. Yeah, there we go. The little fish running around.
Knives and forks become a big angry giant. That's really me not liking it. A lot.
Happens every day.
Now here's the best part of the game. When we see our old buddy. You'll see who I'm talking about.
Gosh, we've missed you, partner. Glad you could make it. But first, how was Aida? Well, we had to make do with this new specimen here.
I've been trying to get here for over 4 hours, Peter. Traffic is a little blocked right now.
Here it comes.
Wait. I know that thud.
Winston, what do you see out there?
It's me. It's clean and soft and white. And you all are.
Thank you guys for watching this Rick Says Spit Is, and this is Ghostbusters for the Xbox 360. I love this game.
Not again.
Ghostbusters.